wake up. You are in a frightening nightmare, and it is all very real. Written by a truth soldier. http://danieltowsey.wordpress.com. This is not a Hollywood, television, or corporate media fiction. This is not fiction at all. Have you looked at the sky lately? They have created an artificial layer into our atmosphere known as chemtrails. This is a military operation that created a Star Wars shield or reflector shield that operates with the HAARP program. Are you aware of the huge Japanese nuclear waste dump and nuclear reactors unleashing a huge deadly plutonium cloud that will surround the whole northern hemisphere, which will keep killing all breathing life forever? Probably not if you are sheeple that feed on the corporate media diet that causes your brain to starve. Are you aware that all foods from the Pacific and Atlantic Ocean is now contaminated with lethal contaminants and poisons? Do not splash that poison water on your face to wake up. It contains deadly rat poison you call fluoride. Time for breakfast after your nightmare? So you're going to eat some unknown to nature food now. Almost all foods you now eat is genetically modified, and you're not allowed to be told on the food labels of this. You are no longer going to be permitted to eat any natural foods or vitamins. Only artificial foods will be permitted. They already erected humanity's tombstone they call the Georgia Guidestones. I was not kidding when I told you to wake up out of your real-life nightmare. You have been sleepwalking your whole life while living in the dream world that has also been socially engineered and created for you. They have been programming you and all of society into a dream state. Medical doctors no longer save lives. Instead, they just make dying profitable by medically prescribed pain management while they put you through any and all sorts of tortures. The trick is to keep you alive as long as possible to maximize profits. And when the profits die, so will you. So are you thinking that I am the one dreaming? Wake up. You are still dreaming if you think that none of what I have said is real. Okay, I have tried to wake you before. I have been waking people up on the internet since year 2000. Do you not realize that your mind will never actually wake up until you start using it? I am not a fiction writer. I am just a simple farmer. I have been planting seeds of truth to feed the minds of the simple masses. I just wish you would know how to do it for yourselves. Do you not know how to plant a seed? It is really easy. All you have to do is go look for the seeds and then just sow them onto this planet. The only thing that will wake you up now and save you is to plant the seeds of truth. You will never be awake until you start eating the natural and energizing produce of the seeds of truth. I have been planting the seeds to save your lives. My soil was created by God. But now they have contaminated that soil with unimaginable chemicals, poisons, hazardous wastes, genetic pollution, and wake up. You are sleepwalking into and entering a new dark ages. This dark ages will be eternal if you do not start thinking. But first, you need to know how to think. Pure truth is your only salvation. Truth is an action. Truth can only exist if you live it. Truth is an absolute, and the further from truth you go, the closer you get to the opposite absolute. That being total insanity. The New World Order are completely insane. They have even written it in stone that they intend to bring about your death. They have written it on humanity's tombstones they erected in 1981 up on a hill in Georgia. They are called the Georgia Guidestones. They have begun the new eternal dark ages. They have done it while you sleepwalked and refused to do some mental exercise with truth. For truth is complete mental health, as the opposite is insanity. You need to act for pure truth now or you will be dead not only on the inside, but also on the outside. You are now already entering the NDA, New Dark Ages, also known as the NWO, New World Order, which is based on old world lies. They are both the same thing. Wake up. This is your last chance for salvation. You cannot save yourself without seeking and then speaking pure truth. When the seeds of truth are sown, the grassroots truth revolution will blossom from the enlightenment. You need to get yourself some light. You need to open up your life to the Son of God. Now. Only truth will save us. Wake up. God is the truth. Or you will stay in your sleep and nightmare for eternity. In the new dark ages, being 6 feet under or further onto hell. I told you. You are asleep and in a nightmare. Ask now for the help you need. Only those that know how to think will know to seek truth. Seek and you will find it. God awaits. God is the spirit of pure truth. God loves you, for love cannot exist without it being based on pure truth. If you see truth, you will see the light of truth. Here is a miracle message from God. Smy, the Son of God photo at http://danieltowsey.wordpress.com. This miracle is an act of God, which is why I am an activist. Which is why I am a truth soldier. For truth is an action. I am a soldier for God. The only thing I carry is the huge stockpile of wisdom from having lived by truth since I made my very first choice in my life at the age of 4. I promised God that I will always seek truth and then speak the truth I discover. It took me into maturity where I then became who I am. I am a lover. I love all that is natural and beautiful. I have been sharing love with you all my life. But all my life, I have been mostly hated in return for my purity. You have repeatedly tried to kill me. I cannot live without love. God cannot exist without love. Love cannot exist without truth. God only wants your love. If you let pure truth die, then you too will die, for you also cannot live without love. So few today love all that was once pure and natural. The lack of love for Mother Earth has just about completely destroyed the life-giving soil that I have planted my seeds of truth on. But now I see that the chemtrails have begun to block the Son of God from giving the life-giving light. I hope that you who are responsible for the chemtrails realize that God pierced right to your chemtrails' artificial atmospheric shield to show His love. Have another look at the miracle. Have a look at my photograph of the Son of God. Do you not understand that God gave you life and the ability to choose? Have you chosen truth or insanity? You will soon reap your just rewards. It was never said. God forgive them for they know not what they do, it was said. God forgive them not for they know what they do, the end is very near and it is man-made. God never ever wanted to kill his offspring. God is dying for he too cannot live without love. That being the love you show for God. But the first step in your recovery is due to seek truth. If and when you do, you will discover it. God is the first step to your recovery and salvation, for the love of God awaits you. Or if you choose to not choose, then only eternal darkness awaits you. Do you not see that all that God created is being destroyed by those who know no truth? Those who know no truth are completely insane. They actually believe in their minds that Satan is the only God. They actually believe that Satan actually exists. Unfortunately, Satan only exists in the minds of those who know and seek no truth. For there is only one God. Satan only exists in the minds of the criminally insane. I hope you do not mind that I choose to be not insane. That is why I thank God every day for being there for me. It saddens me to see all those that are lost in the darkness of insanity. I pray every day that you wake up and see the Son of God. A small note for you to understand. I have often said that God is a He. That is due to the limitations of man's language, for God is not a he or she. God is a spirit of purity of truth. I will now read my poem. I am in love and I am so happy. I did it. I found my soulmate. It's amazing, my soulmate is so beautiful and perfect. I can count on my soulmate to never deceive me or send me in the wrong direction. My soulmate is always there for me. We always get along because we are in pure love. Our love works because it is based on truth. For without truth, our relationship would be doomed. We are never selfish, for we always give of ourselves. In troubled times, I confide with my soulmate for support. I tell my soulmate my deepest secrets and weaknesses. I don't fear exposing my innermost frailties to my soulmate. It's so amazing what strength can be gained from sharing pure love. Love makes me feel so good that I now can see beauty all around me. I see it in the flowers and the bees. I see it all around me in nature. I see beauty even in the worst of storms. I see it in other people who are in love. Before I fell in love with my soulmate, I walked around and could never see the beauty all around me. I am in love and I am so happy. This pure love is so strong that I now have enough love to give even to the sorriest of souls. Love is so contagious. Once I got pure love in my life, I was strengthened so that I could now share some of it with those around me who have never felt pure love before. This pure love in my life has humbled me so. I could have never found my soulmate if I had not always sought truth and always spoke the truth I discovered. I have been completed as a human with this pure love. I love truth, for without it I would always be lost and deceived. The more my love grows, the more beautiful my soulmate becomes, for love is in the eye of the beholder. I know that my soulmate will always forgive me if I am always willing to face and admit the truth of my wrongdoings. My soulmate will always know if I am not being truthful to myself. There can never be a pure love in my heart if I am not always truthful to myself. For my soulmate's pure love could never reach me if I am not pure in truth. I am in love and I am so happy. I love you, God, for you are the truth and my soulmate. End of poem. So do you now think that maybe you should go and seek the truth? D. Do you now think that you should go and see if what I am saying might be true? Humanity's awakening can save this planet from the criminally insane money masters. Do you even think, or are you sleepwalking into the eternal darkness? So do you now know how to think? The answer is that only those that seek and then speak the truth they discover can think. Otherwise, it may be your end.